because I think she's in a different cage. Now the bees will chew up the rubber bands and carry them out when they're done with them. I'm just trying to it's gonna be nice for those guys. Okay, so go ahead and get this pulled out. I just put them in here to keep them out of the wind a little bit, get their smell a little bit in there. Okay, here goes. You recording?
Yep.
I haven't done this is called a bee bus. I haven't used one of these before. I watched a couple videos. Didn't look that tough. But since I got stung the first time I put bees in this year, I am wearing my suit. The rooster agrees. He's up. And this slides. I think this just slides. Yeah, it just slides. And the queen is right here.
Can I see that?
Yeah, I'll bring it over there in just a second. So we gotta check the queen anyways. Make sure she's in there and alive. So you're moving around in there?
Yeah.
Okay, now. They use a candy plug, so see how the bees are already making wax? Mm-hmm. They've been in there for a little while. So take that wax cover off, and then there's a candy plug in there.
Mm-hmm.
And that usually takes a little while to dig through. And so what I'm going to do is put a marshmallow in there. So I got to figure out how I'm going to do that. I brought a marshmallow. I did. So what I'm going to try to do, there's a second hole here. That's, I think you use that for releasing her directly. I'm just going to clear some of this wax where they had her. I don't think she's marked. Oh, she is. Okay, good. Got a blue dot, because this year the queens wear blue. So all I did is I just popped this cap off and I put the marshmallow in here so they can release her quicker. I think they've been in here with her for a little while. I don't know if I like this. So what that's for is just to give her some attendance. So I'm going to put the hole facing up so that way she doesn't get blocked in there anyhow. Put her up here toward the top, okay, and then she's gonna go in, she's gonna have another one right next to her, okay, just like that. Now the fun part. So they said I can do this on either end. I'm just gonna do it on this end, so I should be able to just pop that over. Okay. Let's see how this works. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
I should be able to just pop them down one more time. Open up this door. Might want to back up a little bit. Might want to back up just a little bit. Back up. More bees flying around, isn't there? Huh?
Hmm?
A lot more bees flying around, isn't there?
Okay, hold on. Let me stay right there. So you can see how many.
You hear how loud they are?
Mm-hmm.
Don't. Give them just a minute. They'll figure it out.
Here.
They're not stinging. They're just very confused. They came from the almond fields in California, and now they're in the middle of an apple orchard in Alaska, and they're very confused right now.
back there on the side.
No, I'm not going to squeeze them. So what I didn't do with the last one, I'm going to do with this one. Even though these ones started eating it pretty quick, I'm just going to go ahead and break some of that off like that. And then put that right here. Then
oh my gosh. Hold on. Look down. All the way. We have so many bees up there.
Where? My head?
Yeah. There's one, there's two.
I'll get out.
They already stain it.
I know. They already poop on it. They don't like the name.
See, look. Even here. See, look at that.
Yeah. A little bit of bee poop.
Yeah.
Want some? Yeah, let's see if I can show them.
It's
because they've been stuck in the cage for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
They needed to fly.